वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल. क्लियरली ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल ना? वेरी वेरी गुड इवनिंग. सो दिस इज अ शॉर्ट सेशन टू हेल्प यू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द कॉम्बैट क्विज एंड वी विल बी हैविंग अ क्विज हियर ऑल इटसेल्फ इन दिस सेशन ऑल्सो. सो एज टू गिव यू अ फील ऑफ अन अकेडमी कॉम्बैट विच इज गोइंग टू बी हेल्ड टुमारो दैट इज 28th ऑफ नवंबर एट 5 PM. सो डू अटेंड द सेशन. So what you will get with Unacademy Plus subscription is access to both live and recorded sessions. If you miss a live session, you can watch the recordings and you can study on the device of your choice. Then you can take the benefits of Iconic subscription. And let us straight away come to this NEET PG Combat. So this is a combat quiz targeting your 4 second year subjects. Actually, FM has now become a second as well as third year subject also. So patho, pharma, micro and FM, these will be the 4 subjects from which you will get MCQs, and based on your All India live rank you can avail the scholarships, like you can avail Unacademy Plus subscription for free if you are rank 1. Then rank 2 to rank 10 can avail 75% scholarship on the Unacademy subscription. Then rank 11 to 50, 50% scholarship, and till rank 200, 51 to 200, 25% scholarships. So this is a golden opportunity to avail the subscription at highly discounted rates. And based on your ranks, you can even avail 100% scholarship, and top 100 rankers will be getting some Amazon vouchers also. So that is also a welcome step. So there are scholarships worth rupees 1 CR and more than that. So do attend the session tomorrow, 28th of November at 5 PM. And the test is free of cost. There are no charges for the test as such. You just need to give the test on either on Unacademy app, learners app, or on Unacademy website. And this one will be a live test. After the test, all the questions you can go through wherever you have marked the questions as wrong. Video solutions will be provided to you. So it's not that the question will remain unanswered. So do attend the session tomorrow at 5 PM. So the subjects will be patho, pharma, micro, FM. From the FM, from the patho, all subjects, the questions have been segregated based on your NEET PG questions, number of questions. So from my subject in particular, you will be getting 11 to 12 MCQs as per our NEET PG sessions. So let us start with the session. And these are the upcoming plus courses which are starting targeting your FMG exams, June 2022 exams, which have started on 24th of November. And this is a 6-month duration course. So you will have ample time for revision also. And a fast track NEET PG revision batch course with the help of retro revision, with the help of MCQs, is starting again on 24th of, has started already on 24th of November. So we are good to go. Let us start with the session. A very good evening to all. So let us start with question number 1. Read the lines of the question. A 30-year-old lady died due to some unnatural cause within 7 years of marriage. The inquest should be done under which of the following options? Mark the correct one in the live chat window. Correct answer goes with. The question is about inquest. Inquest is basically a procedure. Agreed na? Inquest is a procedure. So all the procedures which are done after a crime has occurred. So here a sort of death of a female has occurred due to some unnatural cause. So this is unnatural death within 7 years of marriage, goes towards dowry death. So dowry death will be investigated under which section? That is the question. That is the question. So inquest should be done under 176. Because dowry death, if the female, married female, is dying within 7 years of marriage, the case becomes a case of dowry death. And the word unnatural is suggestive of that thing. that yes, it is not a natural death. If the question was that this death, the complaint of this death will be made under, or FIR of the case will be lodged under, then your answer goes with 304B IPC, which defines dowry death as well as the punishment of dowry death. So keep this thing in mind, simple thing, what the question is trying to ask you. Correct now? Let us move on to next. What is the punishment for dowry death? Minimum 7 years, maximum life imprisonment. Maximum life imprisonment. So what is the rank of judge where this complaint will be lodged? Or which judge can preside over such cases? What is the rank of the judge who can preside over dowry death cases? The rank of judge is decided based on the punishments, and this is the punishment for dowry death. So which rank of judge can preside over this? Answer. Options are assistant session judge, additional session judge, or district judge. So basically, which rank of judge, minimum rank of judge, has this power of life imprisonment? That is the question. So minimum rank of judge having life imprisonment or death sentencing punishment is always additional session. A case is filed at the lowest rank of judge who has that power given in the judicial sections. So yes, additional session has the power of death sentencing, and if he has death sentencing power, obviously life imprisonment power will also be there, starting with this rank. So best answer goes with additional. Additional has lots of D alphabets. Goes with D of death sentencing, the trick to remember. Let us move on to next question. A civil negligence case with a claim of 2 CR rupees should be complained at, or the case should be filed at what rank? Which courts? District Consumer Court, State Consumer Court, National Consumer Court, or directly Supreme Court? So this question is based on the recent changes which have been done in Consumer Protection Act, COPRA Act, shortly called as COPRA, or full form is Consumer Protection Act. And many changes have been done in 2019. And now the complaint for up to 1 CR rupees can be filed at district level. For complaints where the compensation is more than 1 CR as demanded by the victim to 10 CR, the complaint should be directly filed at state level. And for complaints more than 10 CR compensation issues, the case has to be filed at national consumer courts. So answer to this question will be yes, obviously state consumer courts. Correct now? So this is a recent updated thing, can be asked as a new question in any upcoming exam and should be remembered. And this we have covered in our classes, all the updates. Which is the final appealing authority in relation to consumer disputes? This consumer can be any consumer availing any type of services. Medical services is one of the services availed by any consumer, or we say the patient. So for civil negligence cases, usually patient goes to consumer courts for compensation. So suppose he is unsatisfied at district level, goes to state. If unsatisfied is at state, goes to national consumer for appeals, which is the final appealing authority. Final appealing authority will be the highest level of courts. And which is the highest level of court? Supreme Court itself. So the final appealing authority in relation to consumer disputes is Supreme Court itself. C for consumer, C for courts. This will also help you remember. And which is the highest rank of court? Our Honorable Supreme Court. Let us move on to next one. Psychological autopsy goes with which of the following options? Which is correct about psychological autopsy? Which of the following will be correct about psychological adoption? So correct statement goes with yes. Option A is the correct statement, which defines psychological autopsy as assessment of mental state of deceased, means the person whose death has occurred, and his mental state can be assessed. What was the state before death, prior to death? How? By asking questions from relatives or friends of the deceased. Who will do this autopsy? If you are given two options, doctor or investigating officer, what to mark? Who does psychological autopsy, the autopsy doctor or the investigating officer of the case? IO means investigating officer. Who does psychological autopsy? So yes, the correct answer goes with investigating officer. It is the investigating officer who investigates the case. And this is a part of investigation. What is the purpose of doing this? Purpose is to estimate the manner of death. To estimate manner of death, whether death is accidental, suicidal, or homicidal. Use of imaging techniques for postmortem examination is which technique? What is the name of this type of autopsy? This is virtual autopsy. Virtual autopsy, also called as vertopsy. Vertopsy or virtual autopsy is same thing. Use of imaging techniques, and this is the future of forensic medicine department. Nowadays, DM courses have also started, super specialist courses in medical toxicology. And remember the types of incisions, autopsy incisions, very important topic, types of autopsy techniques, dissection techniques. Those are very important topics. Let us move on to next one. Bitter almond odor is associated with which poisoning event? Bitter almond odor. Is associated with bitter almond odor is associated with cyanides. Cannabis is associated with burnt rope odor, burnt rope. H2S is associated with rotten fish or egg, rotten egg odor. Rotten fish-like odor is associated with question of FMG exams. Rotten fish-like odor is associated with phosphites. Mainly which phosphites? Aluminium and zinc phosphites used as. Zinc phosphide is used as rodenticide. Aluminium phosphide is used as insecticide, pesticide, as well as grain preservative. All the phosphites, they have a fishy odor. Then what is the odor of nitrobenzene? Answer goes with shoe polish odor. Shoe polish. So these are the recent questions. H2S and phosphites. Then bitter almond, burnt rope, they are all-time repeat questions. So this type of odor is itself an important question zone, the table of odors. Which cavity will be opened first in any poisoning case to get the odor of the poison? Head cavity, chest cavity, abdominal or pelvic? Which cavity you will love to open first to get the odor of poison? Any cavity which is contained like skull cavity. Head cavity is opened first. In a poisoning case, because the odor is contained very nicely there, because the skull is a closed cavity. Answer this one. During visceral preservation, a very, very important topic, hot topic for any exams. While conducting autopsy on a dead body, stomach is preserved with intestine in a jar. In another jar, liver is preserved with which other organ? Which other organ? This is a repeat question of FMG exams. Repeat. Recent repeat question. Most common wrong answer is spleen. The answer to this question will be kidneys. Answer will be always kidneys. So this question is based on basics of visceral preservation, where you understand why organs are preserved in a poisoning case. So when a poison is consumed, it goes through our GIT, stomach and intestines. Then it will go to liver for metabolism. Liver will have gallbladder. Then somewhere here will be your spleen. And here are our kidneys. So the poison has to go through absorptive phase, metabolic phase, and excretory phase. Absorptive phase of a poison is estimate can be, if the poison was in absorptive phase, and suppose the death of the person has occurred, it maximum chances of detection will be from stomach and intestine. That is why we preserve stomach and intestine here. Then to determine the poison from their metabolic phase, suppose the poison was in metabolic phase and death of the person has occurred, maximum chances of detection will be from liver. So we preserve about 500 grams of liver with gallbladder. Now liver is to be preserved with which other organ, means the examiner wants to know that which phase is left. The excretory phase of the poison was happening. The poison was in that phase when it was getting excreted through kidneys, and now the death of the person has occurred. Maximum chances of detection will be from kidneys, and that is why we preserve half of both kidneys. So this stomach and intestine is preserved together in one jar, and we can label that as jar number one. Liver and kidneys are preserved in jar number two, plus minus spleen. We can preserve, we cannot preserve spleen depending on the type of case, but spleen has to be specifically preserved in which poisoning? Spleen is specifically preserved in which poison? Always remember cyanides. Maximum chances of detection of cyanide is from splenic tissues. And spleen also gives very good results for your DNA analysis. Like if a question is asked that which visceral organ gives best results for DNA fingerprinting or DNA analysis, the answer goes with, for a visceral organ, the answer goes with spleen. But it's not that spleen is to be preserved in every poisoning case. It is estimated by the doctor based on the findings. You can preserve. There is no harm in preserving spleen. But yes, that will also correlate with your metabolic phase itself. The liver is already doing that work. The question was, which organ will be useful to detect the poison from excretory phase? That is why the better answer will be kidney. Got the question, got the answer now? Don't mark it wrong next time. What is true regarding euthanasia? Which of the following statements are true? All types are allowed in India, only passive, only active, all types prohibited in India. What do you think? What is euthanasia? Eu means good. Euthanasia means death. So euthanasia is basically good death, or we say mercy killing of a terminally ill patient to remove his pain, because the person sooner or later is going to die. So mercy killing, whether it is allowed in India, if allowed, which type? So always remember, passive euthanasia, based on our Honorable Supreme Court guidelines, passive euthanasia is allowed in the country, in our India. Passive euthanasia is allowed. What is the best example of passive euthanasia? Withdrawal of life support system. You are not doing anything actively. You are just withdrawing the life support system of a terminally ill patient. Withdrawal of life support. And let the person have a good death instead of that extreme pain. Active euthanasia is allowed in other countries like Belgium, Netherlands. And active euthanasia, best example will be like giving injection of potassium chloride directly to the patient, inducing hyperkalemia, killing the person by ventricular fibrillation. Active euthanasia is not allowed in India. Answer this one. Juvenile Justice Board is presided by which rank of judge? Which rank of judge presides Juvenile Justice Board or Juvenile Courts? Which rank of judge? answer goes with first class judicial magistrate, where the magistrate is called as principal magistrate. First class rank now is referred to as principal magistrate in juvenile courts. Recently, one question was asked in your exams that if the victim is of 17-year-old, he will be directed to which courts? Answer was juvenile courts or juvenile boards. Correct na? So juvenile justice board deals with those accused people who are less than 18-year-old, and less than 18-year-old is said to be a child in India legally. So who is a child in India? A person less than 18-year-old. And if this 18-year-old is in conflict with law, if this child is in conflict with law, means he has done something which is illegal or an offense. Now, the courts which will come into play is Juvenile Justice Board, and which will be the presiding officer, first class judicial magistrate, along with two female social workers. Answer this one. Dying declaration comes under. Dying declaration comes under. It will come under IPC sections or Evidence Act section. That is the query. Or CRPC section. If you know this, you will mark the answer, even if you don't remember the exact number. So that what is dying declaration? Dying declaration is an evidence of a person which is recorded when the person is about to die. It can be recorded by any person, best if recorded by a magistrate. Yes, it has to be 32 section of Indian Evidence Act. Other question which can be asked from this root question is whether it is oral or documentary. What do you think? Dying declaration is oral evidence or documentary evidence? These are your two options. Dying declaration is oral, documentary. Which type of evidence for our courts? Think, think. This can be a new question, and many of you will mark it wrong. Why? Because you will think that the person is saying something, but the person is saying something and it is being written by someone. That written statement is your dying declaration. That written statement is a document referred to as dying declaration. It has to be a type of documentary evidence. Understood? Which type of evidence has more weightage in our Indian courts, oral or documentary? Answer is always oral. Why? Because cross-examination of the witness is possible. Cross-examination of the witness is possible. Cross-examination consists of two important aspects, that this is the part of examination which has no time limit. No time limit is there. And leading questions are allowed during cross-examination part of a witness. So these types of examination of witness is another very hot topic. Answer this one. Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act 2020 allows abortion up to. अब कहां तक abortion कर सकते हैं? Medical termination कहां तक कर सकते हैं? Legally. Legal abortions are allowed now up to. All of you must be aware of this change now. Earlier it was till 20 weeks. Now it can be done till 24 weeks and even beyond 24 weeks if there is substantial fetal abnormality. So for beyond 24 weeks of MTP, if the pregnancy is beyond 24 weeks and if there is substantial fetal abnormality, how will the abortion go ahead? The abortion will go ahead on the verdict given by a team of doctors in the form of a medical board will be constituted under this act. The case will be referred to a medical board consisting of which doctors? Obs gyne doctor, then a pediatrician, and a radiologist or a sonologist. radiologist or a sonologist, and their opinion will guide that whether abortion is to be allowed or not based on the medical condition of the female, based on the assessment of this abnormality. Answer this one, the most reliable test for identification of a blood stain. Most reliable test is, or we say most confirmatory, or the question lines are gold standard confirmation for identification of a blood stain is, gold standard confirmation is always benzidine, Teichmann's, Takayama or spectroscopy. The answer goes with always spectroscopic examination of the sample. Benzidine test was used previously as a screening test, but now it is not preferred because benzidine leads to urinary bladder carcinoma. This test is not done nowadays. Teichmann's and Takayama are confirmatory tests. They are not a screening test. They are confirmatory microscopic tests where crystals are formed and looked under microscope. So if you see such crystals, dark brown rhombic crystals, they are seen in positive cases of which of the following? They are seen in positive cases of which of the following? Dark brown rhombic crystals are seen in positive cases of dark brown rhombic. Always remember the color. Instead of focusing towards the shape, remember the color. That will help you remember, recall the test. So always remember, there are two important tests, Teichmann's and Takayama. These are for red stain analysis, whether this red stain is blood or not. TT test, table tennis test. Table tennis racket has red colors on one side. That will help you correlate. So in Teichmann's, we get dark brown rhombic crystals. What is the output in Takayama? Under microscope, we get pink feathery crystals. So focus towards the color rather than shape. Even if you get an image-based question, look at the color of the crystal, because the images are usually not that much magnified. Correct, na? So from tomorrow onwards, I will be having your FMG revision sessions on Unacademy app from 9:30 in the night to 10:30. So starting 28th of November, this session will continue till 3rd of December for quick revision topic wise. Topics I will be sharing on the Telegram group shortly by midnight today itself. All the sessions will also be prepared and I will share the enrollment link also. All the students who want to revise FM subject, they can revise. These will be special live sessions on Unacademy app. And do give this combat quiz, which is going to be held on 28th of November, that is tomorrow, in the evening at 5 o'clock, to avail these benefits. To avail all these benefits in the form of scholarships based on your All India Live ranks. So, which are the subjects which are going to be covered? Path, Pharma, Micro, FM. Number of questions will be at par with your NEET PG distribution. Level of questions will also be there as per NEET PG formulations. Like there will be some simple questions, some moderate and some tough. And you can also win these Amazon vouchers. So I hope all your queries regarding the combat is satisfied. Many students were of the query that what is the subject which are being covered. So there are four subjects questions. 60 minutes will be the test time. Means 5 o'clock till 6 o'clock, you'll be attempting the live test. Thereafter, you'll be getting your ranks and you can clarify all your doubts regarding your mistakes in the form of video solutions, which will be available. I hope no queries regarding the combat itself. Any queries regarding this NEET PG combat which is going to be held tomorrow? Till rank 200, you can avail plenty of scholarships which are there to grab. And after getting your scholarship, you will be attending the live sessions. You will be availing the plus subscription features. So starting tomorrow, we'll be having our FMG revision sessions in the night, 9:30 to 10:30. The details I'll be sharing shortly by midnight today itself. All the very best for your upcoming exams. All the very best for your preparation. Time to end the session. Bye-bye.